We often have a series of data which varies in a regular way over time. If we look, for example, at this data, which is recorded over 3 years for each quarter, so we have spring, summer, autumn, winter, and then quarter five is spring of the next year, and so on. If we plot the data, the sales data, we go to insert, we want a simple line graph. That will do. We can see there's a regular pattern. Low in spring, up in summer, down slightly to autumn, down again for winter, and then back up to spring. Now what we would like to do is to try and even out those cycles, that seasonal variation. And we can do this by using moving averages. Let's move this out of the way for the moment and see how we do this. The idea is to take an average of four successive quarters. Now the problem with the number four is that it's even, and there isn't really a middle number. The middle number is 2.5, so we have to use a bit of a trick. Let's see how that works. I'm going to record here the sum of the first four quarters. So this will be equals the first quarter plus the second plus the third plus the fourth. That gives me 21. And I'm now going to click and drag this to get the successive sum of four quarters. We go down to here. So this number, for example, 22, is the sum of 5, 7, 6 and 4. It's the second to the fifth. It still includes one of each sort of quarter, one spring, one summer, one autumn, one winter. So we now have four quarters added up, but as I say, we don't quite know where to put them. This 21, in a sense, goes in between the second and third quarter, and the 22 goes between the third and the fourth quarter. If we now combine these, then we will get something that very much represents the third quarter there. So I'm going to now find the average of the first four quarters plus the second four quarters. So I take that number plus the next one, and I divide by the total number of quarters I've now included, which is 8. And that gives me 5.375. And I can now click and drag that, like so. And that now gives me a series of moving averages. 5.375 is the first four quarters plus the next four quarters divided by 8. And it sits very comfortably opposite the third quarter. The next one is the second four quarters plus the third four quarters. So again, I'd have to divide the total by 8, and this very much goes against the fourth quarter. If we now plot these two together, we'll see how this moving average has got rid of the seasonal variation. So we go to insert, we do a line graph, and now we can see the two together. The original graph with its regular variations, and now the red graph is the moving averages, and as I say, that's evened out these seasonal variations, and we get a very clear picture of the underlying trend. Notice though that we don't get values for the first two nor the last two, because these averages require four successive quarters, and we run out of quarters by the last two, and we didn't have them at the first two to do a complete summation. So we've got less data, but it gives a clear picture of what's really going on. And we could use that to predict future behaviour then.
Okay, Mary, so let's have a look at this one. So solve x plus 2x equals 12. So what do you think you do first?
Okay, well, I want x on its own, so I would put x equals 12 minus 2x.
Okay, so a lot of the time we want to get x by itself, but what we want to do first is get all of these x's together. So can you see anything we can do with this? Get all these together in one place.
Oh, okay, it's 3x, isn't it?
Yeah,
so
absolutely.
3x equals 12. Oh, and so x equals 4.
Brilliant, spot on, well done.